Hey there friends, welcome to Federance. I will show you Federance skin. It's a video that I've been waiting for a really long time. Now it's about time to make it, so let's cross our fingers. Let's get started. I will show you how to customize the skin. First thing you need to do is go to the setting button, skin design. Start with the buttons at the beneath. You see movies button, click on it. Disable, you won't see the button at the home screen now. I will show you. No movie button. I get back to the skin design. Click. Let's enable it for now. Rename, of course, you can change the name of the button. Choose icon, you can choose local or remote. Let's select local for now. You have a list in here. You can choose icon or choose whatever you like, really. Move the item, it's very simple, you just click, you move the movie, say, to the kids, so they swap location, and get back to the movie. Next thing we have is the button color, let's click, you have a very large list of colors, just pick one, double click, save, very simple. Next thing is background fan art, again, local, remote, let's choose remote for now. Let's go to the Google, say fan art movie. Let's pick this one, copy, paste. Okay, now we set it up, but you don't see it because of these options, random background. If I disable it, you will see, okay? What random background does, it's because this button is connected to the movie widget. You can see in here the small icon of the movie, so it's connected to the movie widget, and if I click yes, it takes the fan out of one of the widgets in here. So if, for example, I pause on Me Before You, this is the fan out you will see when you go to the movie button. Okay, so for now, let's click no. This is the fan art we want to see. Sub menu, you click. There you can add more sub menus. This is enabling the sub menu. Okay, I will show you. Create new item first. Let's pick an add-on. Video add-on. YouTube. Where is it? Okay. Create menu item to here. We have it now. Let's create another one, just for example, video library, movies. To generals, create menu item here. Okay, so now we have sub menu. It's enabled, you can see by the strip in here. If I click here, you won't see it. So let's enable the sub menu for now. Let's see how it works. We go back to the home screen. Now when we click on the music, which is a movie button, okay, you see your options in here. Okay, let's get back. Now in the sub menu, you have a similar list of options, disable, enable, rename, choose icon, button action, you can change it. Actually, you can see the current action in here. It's direct to YouTube plugin. Move item down, I can swap location like that, move it back up, very easy. Remove item, just delete it, yes, very easy thing. Next thing we see is a reset button. I want to make it back to as it was before, so I just click on the reset button. It tells me that it's also related to the kids, so let's reset them both. There you see, here is the kid button, here is the movie button, just as before. Now password protection, let's click on the kids button, use password protection. You see the lock in here, we get back to the home screen, I click on it. This button is locked, but you haven't set a password. Okay, so what we are going to do is going back to the skin design, skin design, their search for passlock, use password protection. Set your password. Now it should work. Click on the kids button, enter the password. That's the right password, we can get on. Very easy. Next thing. By the way, now the lock is open, so it will reschedule locking in 15 minutes. You can change it in here. There are some other options in here, like add-ons locking. If you put the ID of the add-on, like say plugin.video.federance.kids, I see it in here. You see the command. This is the ID of the add-on. I want to protect it. So let's reset the password so I get the lock again. Set the password again. Okay, this is the add-on we blocked. Now we see how it works. We just go to the add-on from wherever we want. Just for the example, we go from the video add-ons. This is the add-on we blocked. So now every time we enter this add-on, we will get enter password window. So if we don't know the password, we cannot use the add-on. So that is that. Let's get back. I think we are really done with the buttons in here and the sub buttons. What we can do more is maybe the widget. There you have the widget. You can click, choose name, button action, for example, you know how to do that already. Choose add-on, video add-on, federal kids. Create menu item to here. Okay. So changing the icon, you know, rename, disable, enable, move the item, exactly the same. So we cover the widget as well. Next thing we can do is the skin design in here. There are lots of stuff here, actually. So start with the on buttons. We have a buttons layout. Now we set on the default one. Let's click. The next one is panel. It looks like that. There are some more buttons layout. You can change to panel 2. Next is horizontal. It looks like that. Horizontal 2, vertical, check the vertical, look like that. You can change the language, say for Hebrew, so it will look like that. Let's get back to the English. Horizontal 3. And I think that's it. But you can cycle them over and over again, of course. Button shapes. What you have about the shapes? Let's click. Now it's the rectangles. It looks like that. Circles. Triangles. Pillows. Hexagons. That is the default. Selection marker is that. Now you see. The color, of course, the color of the selector marker. Pick whatever you like. Selection marker focus is that. So every time you focus a button, it looks like that. Shadow button. A little bit hard to notice, but you see. Overlay is that. Oh. Bevel. Like that. If I turn them both off, it looks like that. Very cool features. scroll button, static transparency. It's let's click no and you will see. So I click no, so there should not be any static. So after a few seconds, you will see that the other button that are unfocused will get fade. So this is what it does. Transparency for unfocus, very simple, set to 20 for just to show you. So every button I'm not focusing on will have a transparency of 20%. Let's get it back to default. Color and focus icon label, the same like this, just for colors. So this will be the color of the unfocus icons and their labels. Very cool. And for the focus, same, just for the focus, azure. So this is how it looks for the focus now. Of course, you can play with it whatever you want. If you don't like, you wanna get back to the default. Here it is, default. Default, here it is. We are back to the default. Reshape icon. Reshape, it's make the icon to be exactly the same shape of the button. Here are the shapes, okay? Let's pick something that is a little small. Just to show you how it works. Okay, circles will do. Let's get back to the reshape icon. Let's click yes. You won't notice anything because the icon is not really big. So let's change one icon. Choose icon. Let's pick from the web. Go to Google. Now we say, icon, let's pick something, this one should do, it's quite big, you see, it should do fine, let's copy, maybe it's that, yeah, okay, can go back, paste it here. Now we get the icon. You see how it's not even close to the shape. So what we do? We click on the reshape. There we get the shape of the icon, circle. Oh. Now it's maybe we want it to be exactly the shape. So there is another setting here called big icons. You see, you click on the big icons and it make it to fit the button. You see, let's see another example with another shape. Triangles, you see how it's fitted? Let's look again. So here we have the big icons. I tell him to not use the big icon, reshape. Don't use the reshape, it looks like that. You see? Now I do reshape, everything gets back to the shape of the icon. And big icon, make it bigger. So those are those two options. Submenu action, just read what it says. If you click on it, when you make a sub button like that, we have here somewhere, I think. Oh no. Okay, let's make one quick. Create new item. Video library. Movies. Enable. Okay, now it's enabled. Let's click on the setting here. Okay, submenu action, yes. Now what it does, when I click on this, it will get me to the main action. So I don't have to choose anything, but if I want to choose, I press on the down arrow. There I go, I get the submenu list. So default, it's always show you this window. So if you don't want to see this window and just on demand, you click here, yes, then you click the down arrow, the submenu will open. Transparency, submenu mark. I will show you with the different shape. It will be much more easier to notice. Okay, with this one will be great. Here is the submenu mark. Here, you can make transparency. So you see the transparency is now 20%. Let's get back. We are almost done with the on button tab. Color submenu mark, same, just for the color. You see how the color change. So this is the submenu mark. Button label position, now it's inside, now it's outside. You can play with it. Mini settings and power buttons. This is very cool. Let me show you something before I click on that. Let's disable some button. Okay, I disable it because we have some more in here. See those three buttons? And I want you to notice something. So this is off, this is off. There is button here called hide unactive button. So I click and what it's not active will disappear. Okay, this is good if you want to see exactly how it looks like. Because if I go back to the home screen, it looks exactly like that. You see, identical. So if you want to play and see how it looks like, just click in here. So this one will not mess with you. Okay. Skin design, mini settings and power buttons, you click yes, and there you see them. 1, 2, 3, they move to this small area, which is really nice if you ask me. You can go to them very easy. So this is what it does. Now we basically cover the home buttons tab. Let's go to the fan out. Fan out home enable, of course, if I disable, you won't see the fan out. Color fan out transparency, you can change the transparency of the fan out. Fan out on full screen, of course, if I click yes, full screen fan out. Clear fan out, you can make it unclear. And what it does is basically if I put the fan out on home screen full, you see, you won't see the fan out there. But there are some other things that you can do with it. I will show you. So let's make it full screen for now. Transparency of the color fan out background. You can change the transparency of the color that you don't see right now because we didn't set any color. This is the color. You can make a color, say apple green, save. So it looks like that. Of course, if I change the transparency, you will see the fan out more clearly. You see? So you can play with it. The clear fan out now will make it clear, even with the color, but the color still affects it. You see? Lightly affects it. The texture fan out background, you can make a texture. It will be a little bit hard to notice. Let's make the fan out not clear so you can see. Texture. To make it easier to notice, I will disable the fan out and make the texture again. Let's have a more light color. Is it the texture of the veneer? Let's get back to the fan art. You see the texture? You have some other options you can play with. Like that. Let's make it clear again. Fan art submenu. Well, if you click yes, you can set fan art for the submenu. Here we have some submenu. You can click on the movies and set a fan art. Okay. If you don't have the settings on, then the fan art of this button of the movies, for example, will be such as the main button, what you see in here. So this is that. Color main background. Main background is for this layout. It's this area. Let's make a color for it. See? Well, you can change the color. Texture is the same as we saw before, just for the main background. See? You can play with it. Multi fan art, it's basically if you want to have a lot of fan art for a button, you click yes. Then what you do, you go to your button and choose a fan art, you choose local for that, and multi files. You see, now you can have single file or multi files because of that previous options we clicked yes on. So you click multi files, you pick up your folder where you have to make a folder with lots of pictures inside. So I should have something like that. Okay, so this folder, I click OK, and now you will see that the fan art is very dynamic now. In a few more seconds, the fan art will switch to the next one. So this is what it does. I'll get back. Multi fan art. Now, for the multi fan art, you have default time per image. You can change the time. 5 seconds, 7 seconds, every 10 seconds to switch the fan art. Crossfade time, every time the fan art is changing, there will be some more fade. You will notice it soon. Say 2 seconds. So in order for it to work, you need to get back to the home screen. Now it should work. So let's switch fan art, you see the fade timeout. So this is what it does. This is the fade. Let's get it back to normal. The shuffle fan art, if you have a multi fan art, of course, it will be randomized. So you won't see the same fan art over and over again after each one. So if you like to use it, enable fail safe fan art to our last options now. When you click yes, what it does, it say if you go to a button, let's say the movie, I click on it, and now I should be inside the movie collection. So you see there is a fan art now. Although we don't really have a fan art for the current button I select, but this is because the fail-safe fan art. So it will always give you something to look at. Now, if I don't use this option, let me show you. So what will happen now when I click on the movies, I don't see fan art. I see the color fan art that we chose. So this is the color we chose, something like green. So this is what you see. So that's it for the fairly safe fan art. Now we move to the upper design. So we have the, from the top, transparency of the top bar. You see the top bar with the time and the icons, and that one that tell you we are in the skin design window now. So you can change the transparency for it. you start to notice, yeah? The color, of course, you change the color. Top bar size, you can make it a little bit bigger, like that. Icons, you have icons for the internet, for the weather. Now I disable them if you don't like. If I only like the weather, I can keep only the weather. Color of font top bar. So this is the font, what we see. You can change it. Transparency video information. It's the one strip down, the big one that give you information for what you are selecting now. You can change it, the transparency now. Next thing you can do is let's change it a little bit more. So now we see it on 60% color. You can change the color, of course. This is the size of it. You can make it bigger like that. And this is the color for the font. So you can play with it as well. RSS, I don't have RSS enabled, but you can change the time for the RSS and the visibility to show RSS always. RSS will be at that position at the middle, so always to show it, or only when you are on the home screen. So what else we have? RSS in video audio playback. If you don't want to see RSS when you play a video or watching something, you click yes. Of course you click no, sorry. Yes, if you always want to see the RSS. So this is for the upper design. And now the menu buttons tab, what we have is the background menu. Let's see something, okay. The background menu, the background, you see now we have no background. Now it does have a background. Transparency, it's for the background. You can change the transparency of the background. We saw in here. Main color, you can change the color of the background. It also affects all the colors in the skin inside. So when you get back to the skin and enter some settings or another window, this is the color you will have. Let's see if we can have a quick example of that. You see the color in here. Let's get back. You see the color. This is the main color. So you better pick something that you really like. Menu buttons. This is the 2D dimension. Of course, it affects all the buttons. Even if I go to here, you see, now it affects that. This is the background. So this tab affects a lot more than you think. So you have to play with it in order to see exactly how it looks like. For example, even if I go, even in here, you see, the background and the button have 2D dimensions now. And even if I click on button action in here, you see even this look different, the background in here. Here you see the two dimensions. So it affects a lot, okay? You will have to play with it. What else we have is the 2D shadow button. You can add shadow, you can add overlay like that, bevel, overlay, stroke. Okay, this is the options for the 2D. Color and focus. Okay, what we don't focus, we want to have some kind of color. So for the bottom, you see, everything changed and it affects a lot of other windows in the skin. This is for the focus one. Once we focus, we look like that. Transparency, if you want to have more look like look similar to transparency skin or something, you just change it. Everything will have a transparency. You see in here, there is a slight transparency for the button, you can see underneath it. And of course, it affects a lot of others windows. So this is it for the menu buttons. Keyboard. Before we start with the keyboard, let's get back to normal. You have here in the skin design, not in the skin design, yes, in the skin design, advanced and reset configuration. Let's reset all the colors to normal. So it's not affecting my buttons and my settings and everything, just the color. So this is the default color. Now we got it. The next tab is the keyboard. So we have a virtual keyboard in Kodi. You can change the transparency of the virtual keyboard, color keyboard background. So this is how the keyboard look like. Now it's have a little transparency because we chose to. You can change the color. This is the background color. Color unfocused keyboard. Okay, you can change the color for the keyboard. So like that, you see? The virtual keyboard background color. So this is that. Edit text, this is the font, of course. You can change the font color. Say something like yellow. See, you can play with it. The font title, keyboard font title color, so you can change it. And that's it for the keyboard. Now mouse, you can choose the mouse icon. This is the current one. This is the number one. This is the number two. This is the number three. Of course, if you have something that you really like, you can just send it to me, contact me. I will edit. It's very simple, actually. Color, you can change the color. Like that, you see how the color change. Let's see another example with different shape. Now you see how the color change. Extra mouse support. If you click yes, if you really like to play with the mouse, so you click a lot of button with the mouse, some buttons won't be able to be used because you have to click on the arrow. So if you click yes, another window will pop up and you can use the mouse to select. If you don't like with the mouse, just disable it. Widget. Okay, so about the widget, what we have. First of all, the buttons layout. You see here, we have the widget for the TV show. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and another 5 in here. Potentially, of course. So, we can change the buttons layout, say to 7. Now you see 7 in here. And you can play with it a little bit more. Shape, you can have a shape that match your buttons. So now my buttons in a pillow, so it will match it. If you like, you can do it like that. Of course, if you change the shape of the widget will change as well. Bigger labels, if you want it to have a little bit bigger, you see the, let's see the movies, actually, The Nice Guy, okay? Bigger label, now it's a little bit small, so you can have it bigger. Maximum of movie TV show widget item. You see here we have 7, 8, 9, 10, 10. So you can see more than 10. So if you change it in here, you can change the maximum. So say 18. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and you have more. Okay, you can play with it. And fan art widget will actually let you set up a fan art. So now you can set up a fan art for this specific button. Like that. So This is the TV show fan art, and this is the widget that is related to the TV channel, and it have its own fan art. Set movie widget. Of course, we have widget for movies, for TV show, for everything. So I want the movies widget to be for the movies button, but I can change it to be for the kids button or whatever button you create so you can play with it. So now the kids button will have it. You see, this is the kids button, and it actually have the fan art of the widget of the movie. So this is that. Same for the TV show, same for the weather. For the weather, we also have a widget, show widget labels background. So there is a background in black, you see, next to the label. You can remove it if you don't like, so it looks like that. This is the font color. You can change the font color. So everything I don't choose will have a different color. And this is for the focus one. You see? So you can play with it. It's very nice. And that's all for the widget. Now we get back to the volume. Show volume icon. It's that. I don't see it now. I do see it. You can check it with the plus and minus in the keyboard. Choose the icon. Of course, you can choose your own icon if you want and change it. The background color, you can change like that to whatever you like. The color of the icon as well, you can change. Position. If you don't like it to be in the center, you can have it on the top or at the bottom or wherever you like, really. Volume background overlay, so you can change the transparency of the background. So if you do like the background but it's taking too much space, you can make it transparent like that. Volume icon, same for the icon, you can change the transparency. So it looks like that. Show percent, okay. So now I don't see the percent. I actually can't see anything at all. It's very low. So let's check it back. Let's get back to the normal color so I can see something. So now it looks like that. If you want to see the percent, you click yes, see the percent. And mute is when you actually muting the like that. So if it's always show volume level on mute, when you mute, you will see the icon, so you know that you have to raise up your volume. And if you click no, it will auto disappear and you maybe won't know that you have to do that. So dialogues, what we have in the dialogues, it's first of all transparency for the background dialogue. You can click, there are a lot of dialogue like the progress one, so you can change the transparency for it. You have a dialogue okay, dialogue yes no, dialogue select. You can change the settings for all of them. So now you see how it get 60% transparency. You can change the color. Next thing you can do is change the font dialogue title. This is the title. You can change the font color, the font dialogue is the text you see underneath, so you can change it. Save. Reposition, you can change the position center if you like it like that. Just play with the settings. And that's it for the dialogues. Transition, fail time between different skin window transition. That means when you move to another window, say now we are in the skin design and I want to move to the home screen, I just click back. So there is a fail time. You can increase it if you like it. So let's make it to 1 second. Get back to the home. Let's test it again. You see, 1 second. 1 second. So you can play with it. Zoom. This is the zoom you saw when we get in and out. Now there won't be any zoom. It just get fade and get back. No zoom to play with. Transition logo. If you want to have some kind of a logo or pictures when you switch window, so just pick one. Home folder. Let's pick something quickly. Screenshot. Screenshot. Yeah, okay. Let's pick this one. So let's get back. You see? On the please wait, you have some kind of picture until everything is ready again. So, transition logo size, you can make the logo bigger. Now it's a little small. Let's make it larger. Default transition logo position, you can change the position. Now it's in the center. And background. So, the first one was a logo. It should not be on the wall screen. You don't have to use the logo, but if you want to have a background, it will be on the full screen. So let's make something in here. Let's pick an add-on. Okay, feather and fan out. Pick the fan out. So you see, when I switch, you have the fan out and the logo you pick up when you change window. So if you like it, you can use it. This is what it does. What else we have is the touch screen. If you have touch screen or just want to use the mouse with it, you can enable it in here. So now we have the buttons in here. So every time I click here, it gets me back. Every time I click here, it gets me to the home screen. It appears on every window. It supports everything in the screen. So this is must have for the touch device, of course. Size, you can change the size of it. Now it's small, you can make it bigger, you can make it larger. Touch button position, you can change the position. Your right hand, left hand, whatever you like, you can change. Of course, orientation, you can make horizontal or vertical. So that's it for the touch screen. Pass lock, we already covered that, I think. Advanced is our last thing to cover. Reset skin settings, of course, everything will get back to normal, to the default. It may take a few seconds, so be patient. So this is the default. Of course, don't use these options unless you know what you are doing. Reset configuration. There are lots of stuff here. I can reset everything, but this is resetting the design, okay? Randomize everything. This is all about design. It won't affect your buttons and actions and everything you do. So random all, it will make a lot of colors and really randomize the skin, just if you want to play with it to see what you can do. So, of course, it won't look perfect because it's random. So, let's get back. Now I don't have to use the reset skin. What I have to do is just reset configuration, because reset skin will remove everything you did, everything you, every button you made, it will reset everything. So, if you just want to reset the colors and the font, you know, the position of the buttons, So this is what you are looking for, the reset configuration, not the reset pin settings. Reset configuration, you can randomize all, yeah, we know. Reset color transparency, reset the transparency. It's really everything that have transparency will get back to the normal. You can make it random. And let's just play with it if you like. Reset default button name, icon, label. You can choose both or labels, icon, it will reset them. So just for example, if I go back to Hebrew, and now the code is in Hebrew language, but the labels are in English. So I want them to be in Hebrew. I say yes, the labels is enough for me. So now I have everything named to Hebrew. So this is what it does. Let's get back to English language. Get back to the skin design, to the advanced tab. What else we have in here? Save load. Save load. You click on the save load. You can save what you did now. Okay, let's just pick a template for now. A template is something that is ready on the server. You don't have to download it. Say Cody Senior, you can pick Cody Senior. It will take a little bit of time. On Cody Krypton, it takes much more time. I hope they fix it. Just be patient. This is like loading a build. Okay, just with the skin design, nothing like adding you a lot of add-ons and something. So on the button in English, and no, yes, you can choose. Let's just say yes for now. I don't want to change the language. So now we have a different skin. You see, this is a build. So how you make your own build? It's very simple. You play with all the settings you saw right now, and you click save. So if I click here and go to save, it show me all the builds I already saved. So I can make a new one, or let's just pick the test. Okay, you click on the test, yes. So now I made a build called test. I can change the name and say I go to another build template. I go to Classico. Let's pick the Classico. So now we have the Classico build. So if you want to save time, you make the settings one time, you save it, you have a backup, you can move it to another computer, you can load it in a few seconds. It's a very good thing to have and to know. Loading, you can load it back. Of course, this is what I have saved. The template also loading things, but the load is loading from your local directory. So I will show you just in a second where it is. Let's get back to the test we just saved and get it back. What you are looking for is the Cody folder. In the Cody folder, you go to the user data, add-on data, search for the script, feather, and service. There you have it. Classico Plus, Cody Senior, all the others, and here is the test. You see? It's very small file, it's not really like a build you are familiar with. Yes, so this is the build. We did the loading. What else we have? Default path for icon. So every time you choose icon, you will get to the specific path. So let's say I have all my image in here, pictures, click OK. Every time I choose icon, it will take me there, so I don't have to waste time and find it. The same goes for the background. Every time you pick the fan art, you will go to the specific path. Allow location change for default button, so action change. So if I click yes, you can change the action for the default one. So this is a default button. This is also a default button. You can change the action. If you click no, of course, you cannot change the action now. Action and thumbnails. This is our last thing to know. If you click yes, when you choose action, you will also get the poster of the action if it has one. Okay, if you click no, it will just set action over and over. So let's make a quick example now. I go, now I cannot see the action. So allow action for default buttons. This one, change the action and say movies. Click to here and that's it. The action has been changed. You can see at the top. So let's make it clear. Come on, movies. And that's it. So if you want to change the icon as well, you click yes. Button action, pick something, movies, and the icon is changed as well. So of course you can always go back and just change the icon if you like, but this is what it does. We are pretty done with everything in the settings in here. About the loading in here, so if you have something that you saved, as I told you, it comes to this location build. Now there is another thing you should know, and if you want to transfer some add-ons, make it like really build. So what you have to do is to create a folder called Federance, like that, and inside the folder you put the add-ons, user data, whatever you like, but it must be at the following structure, like that. You see, add-ons, and let's make it bigger. Oh, let's make this bigger as well. So now, no, where it is. Okay, so what you see inside the Federance folder should be exactly what you see in here. So I want to have the add-ons and I want to have the user data. So I put them here inside the add-ons. You can pick whatever you like. Okay, so this is what I want. Inside the user data, you can pick whatever you like. So this is what I want to have. Some add-on settings. So what you do next is like that. You take the folder, okay? Even let's just pick the test one, put it in here. Now take the folder inside the test. Now let's get back the test to here. Now what we do, we go back to Kodi, we click on test. Now we're loading the test one that we saved. And notice at the end of the design setup, you will be asked if you want to get extra contents because of the Federance folder. So if you click yes, it will copy the contents of what you put, like add-ons and everything. So now you should see it. You see extra folder found. If I click yes, it will copy the add-ons. So you can copy add-ons like that. So the build come with add-ons and repository and whatever you like. Okay, so you click yes and everything come out. So you have a perfect build that can be used in a second. You don't have to install, reinstall, delete your Kodi. And of course, everything affects the Federance skin. So when you click the save load, it won't affect any other skin. So this is that. Next thing we can maybe show is the skin settings in here. You have the skin design and skin settings. In the skin settings, you have some other options. You will just have to play with them really. Show the skin version if you want on the home screen. Username, you will be granted with a welcome when you enter your Kodi. if you put a username in here, allow tips, you should already know what it is. When you wait with the dialog progress, with the dialog busy, you get some tips. Enable widget, if you don't like the widget, you just click no, no widget will appear. So video and audio, OSD is the buttons player, the play, the stop. So there is two settings for video and audio. If you click yes, you will always see them. If you click no, you have to do something in order to see them. I will show you now. So in the widget, let's just get to the trailer of a movie. Now in the trailer, you have the buttons in here. So of course, this is the stop. This is going back. This is going forward. And subtitle. Here you have the audio. If you want to increase the volume, you press up, you press down. You see, you cannot really press up and down with the mouse. But if you really like to, I will show you how. So if you click here on the top, you see more options. You see, like the audio in here. Also notice here all the 2D dimensions. You see, it's affected. Here, because we choose the 2D dimensions and the colors and everything we chose is here, and the audio one, and this button, get it to the bottom. If you don't like it on the top, you can change. Let's get back to the screen settings. So if I click yes, always show. Now this one will always appear. Okay, this one. So this is what it does. Doing full screen. If you update your library and you don't want it to show when you play on the full screen, click yes. Rating for a movie, for a TV show. If you like it to be more, I don't know how to say it, but I made it in order to have a better rating system. You just read and try it and see what you like. The no is the default one that almost every other skin uses, and this is what I think is best. So get familiar with it and see what you like. Plot. So the plot for the movie, how you like it to be, from right to left, from right to left, from left to right, justify, center, just play with it, generate pictures. Of course, there are genres that you can see. If you click no, you won't have a generate pictures. Enable next hired. You, some of you know what it is. It show you the next episode. So if you like it, click yes. Enable time. So what is the time now? Change the clock. You can change to show you date and time, just hour, just date, whatever you like. Music in slideshow and screen saver. So every time you make you enter a slideshow or have a screen saver open up, you will be greeted with music that you like. So just play with it. It's a very cool feature. Trailers, when you click on a trailer, it will open in full screen always. So if you click yes, view changelog, if you want to be greeted with every time the skin is getting update, you click yes. So if the skin got update and you enter your Kodi, it will show you that it got update today, yesterday, whatever you like, and give you the information. So total days for displaying recent updates. If it's zero, it's only for the current day. If you want to see it over and over again, so you don't miss anything, you can change the setting in here. Startup tab, you can change the volume on startup. So every time you get back to your Kodi, the volume of the Kodi will be 40, for example. Music at startup, every time you open Kodi, you will be greeted with music. You can choose your own music in here. Of course, if you make a save and make a build, everything in here will be inside the build. So other users just have to load it up and that's it. So we have the music. If you choose a music that you like, same for the video that you like. The startup video delay, 1 second, 2 seconds, whatever fit for your hardware. Custom fan out on startup. So when the code is startup, it will be it will have a specific fan out that you choose, and it will be following with the music if you like, and after that the video. So it's up to you. Advanced, you have the reset skin setting that you know, and debug information. That's it. So we go back and I want to show you the movies library. Let's click on it. This is how it looks like. You can see all the information. You can right click, play the trailer from here. You can play the video, get information. If you click here, you get more information about the movies. You can do it also for the actors and director, whatever you like. Here is the director. You can take more information about him. Same for the actors again. I won't show you this now. I don't want to waste any time. More stuff we have in here. This is common. View auto. So auto view, say yes for movies. I want to always have side list. Okay. Side list. So now it's enabled. When I change the view for movies and I go to movies, it will get back to the view I set for auto. So this is it, the auto view. You can do it for movies, TV shows, seasons, episodes, movie sets, and more. Same thing go for the force view. You can click yes and then set a view for anything. View options. So the options is for the side list view, DVD case, you see, disc art, that wider menu, smaller menu, fan art, full screen, not full screen, allowed thumbnails, fan art. Basically, this is only valid if you don't have a fan art. So now we have, I cannot show you this. Show rating, the rating, larger icon or smaller one, enable trailer button, so you can click on the trailer with your mouse. Side video information, this is now side, this is not side information, it's on the top. Video information front side, that, see, that is the difference. And sliding animation, I don't think I can show you this right now. Let's go to another view, or actually let's just go, let's exit to the home screen. Let's see the movies widget. This is the widget. You can click on it and see the movie, or click right here and see the trailer. You can switch from the recently added movies to unwatched movies, so movies in your library that you have not watched yet. You can change the movies to trailer, and then when you click on it, you can see the trailer if you don't have a mouse to click in here. You can refresh the list if you like. You can play random trailers. So you click and you play random trailers. It's very cool feature. You see 1 out of 20. If you stand on this button and click up with your arrow, you will go to the next one in your list. Now it's number 2. Click here. It will give you the playlist. So this is the playlist. You can switch to another video like that. There are some other stuff that you can do in here. I will leave it to you. Let's get back. So let's go to the TV show. This is the TV show. Now we have a different view. So let's go back to the side list for now. Here is the side list. This is the view we already saw before. You can see the next IRED in here. The next time there will be a new episode. There you saw, I watched all the episodes so far. So this is it. Here I have 40 more episodes to watch. We can go to the view options and add DVD case if you like. So I watched part of it. I have 40 more to watch for. You can click, you can enter, see all the information, season 4, watch. Let's get back. So the next view we can have is center list. So this is the center list, look like that. You can change some stuff in here. You can make the side video information to be on the, at the top if you like. Another view we have is line. So this is how the line looks like. Let's close the video for now. You just go up, you see, I go up. Now I can go to the video or get back, go up again, click stop. And this is the line view, look like that. Okay. So let's go to the right side, to the menu, and DVD case is that. Disc art, we know, cover transparency, you can change the transparency for the cover. So let's make it really noticeable. So 40. So just wait a few seconds and 40% for the unfocused one. Enlarge focus thumbnail. Now it's want enlarge. If you like it like that or enlarge, you can make it bigger. Selector frame. Now it don't have selector frame. Now it does have. Up to you. Show rating. So it's the star rating on the poster. Boat mode. It's that. If you like, let's disable it. Video information font size, you know what is it, and that's it. This is the line view. Let's go to the wall view. So this is the wall. There are some options that I will let you see now. So it worked like that. After a few seconds, you get the information. And the options we have are DVD case, we know, okay, and this car upper information window. So if I disable it, the app information won't come. So if you want to get information, you right click and go to information. There you see all the information for the current TV show. Let's enable it for now, find out full screen. If it's not from full screen, it will look like that. Just wait a second. So this is how it looks like. You can have a pan out full screen zoom out. So now we will have a little effect of zoom out. If you like it, you can use it. Cover transparency, let's get it back to normal. Enlarge, you know what it is. Allow thumbnails, fan art transparency. You can set transparency for the fan art. Cover distance, it's a very cool feature. You will see now. So let's click on it. Hop. Now it's looking really big. So you can use it if you like. And that's it for now. Let's go to the top. Change the view. Poster. So this is the poster view. It looks like that. Some options we have are very similar to what we saw in the wall view. The fan out full screen or not full screen. Let's see. Like that. The zoom out, we already saw that. Cover transparency, we saw. Fan out transparency. cover distance. So let's see again the cover distance. So it's really big now. And this is what we have. Let's see. The next one is sidewall. So it's like the wall, but with information at the side. Look like that. Let's go to the right and see what options we have in here. Find out full screen. So this is the full screen or not full screen. Cover transparency, we know. Enlarge, we know. Select a frame, we know. Basically, we know it all. Cover distance, we know. Enable sliding animation. So it's that. If you like it, this is the sliding animation. If you don't like it, you just disable it. You can change the size. So now, if you like it like that, you can see it on the right side and the information on the left. I think that's it. Everything you saw, including these features in the library, are all saved when you make a save for the build, for a backup. Everything is saved. So just save your settings, and if you want, share them with your friend. And I really hope you like the video. I really put a lot of effort in order to make it. I hope you are pleased, and see you next time. Thank you for watching.